Spider-Man. I'm the Green Hulk. Fuck you, Spider-Man, and the boat you rode on.
Today we're building one of my favorite Spider-Man villains, the Green Goblin. Known for effortless cruelty and a knack for bombs, Green Goblin's been a menace in New York for almost 60 years. So how do you build Green Goblin? Well, it's pretty straightforward. First, you need to get goblined up by some magic goop, being able to hold our own against the Spider-Man. Second, we need to be able to throw around pumpkins and have them explode. And lastly, like any good goblin, we need to fly. Wait, how do goblins fly? Good thing you start out as a human. To get 2 free boosts, put them in intelligence and strength. Because, you know, goblins very smart and very strong. And as a human, you get 8 hit points at level 1, you get a speed of 25 feet, you're a size medium creature, and for our heritage, go versatile and pick up adopted ancestry. For what ancestry? Goblin, of course. For our human feat at this level, we're going to pick natural ambition. I'll talk more about that when we get down to our classes later down the line. For background, you're something of a scientist yourself, so I would suggest Clockwork Researcher. Choose free ability boosts, one must be dexterity or intelligence, so pick intelligence and the free boost put into charisma, because come on, it's Willem Dafoe. You're trained in the society skill and the engineering lore skill. You also gain an eye for numbers skill feat, which allows you to estimate how many vials are in a crate or guess how many people are in New York City as of 2002. It's 8 million, he says it in the movie. As a very powerful character, I believe Goblin would be best suited as a dual-class inventor and alchemist. However, I think multi-class is readily available in the general play, which means we need to compromise on our goblin, with either alchemist or inventor. While we can always find ways to build bombs and use them, inventor is the only way we're going to get that glider. So, we're going to main inventor. As an inventor, you're trained in perception, you're an expert in fortitude, trained in reflex, and expert in will saves. For skills, you're trained in crafting, and a number of skills equal to 3 plus your intelligence modifier. So at the end of level 1, 7. Pick athletics, acrobatics, diplomacy, deception, intimidation, academia, lore, and stealth. You're trained in simple weapons, martial weapons, and armored attacks. Your defenses, you're trained in light armor, medium armor, and armor defense. For class DC, you're trained in inventor class DC. When you're an inventor, you also gain a boost to your intelligence, evening out at 16 at this level, as well as 8 hit points plus your constitution modifier every time you level up. Speaking of leveling up, you also gain 4 boosts at level 1, put them in intelligence, constitution, strength, and charisma, for all those important goblin aspects. One of the big features for inventor is going to be overdrive, which means you're attempting to overcrank your body or your construct to maximum overdrive. Attempt a crafting check that has a standard DC for your level. On a critical success, you can add your intelligence modifier to the damage of your attacks for 1 minute. After overdrive is done, you need to wait 1 minute for everything to reset, so you just can't keep spamming overdrive because it's that great. On a success, you only deal half your damage. On a failure, nothing happens. On a critical failure, something explodes, you take fire damage equal to your level. You can't use overdrive again for 1 minute. Because things are cooling down, you need to reset them. For innovation, we're going to be building the glider, which is why we're picking an inventor and not just going straight alchemist. Pick construct as you start out. It's a prototype construct companion, which means you can't ride it just yet. If you use overdrive action, your construct also gains the same overdrive benefits that you do, and it also takes the same amount of fire damage on a critical failure. For its initial innovation, pick accelerated mobility to make it faster. Your innovation speed is now going to be 40 feet, which is going to be helpful when we can finally get on and ride it. Of course, it can always just make the construct explode if you want to. The explosion deals 2d6 with a basic reflex save at first to any creature within a 5 feet emanation around you if you're holding it or using it, or around it. At third level and every level after, your explosion increases by 1d6. If you have a breakthrough innovation class feature, you can choose either a 5 foot or 10 foot emanation from the area to use explode, or even the revolutionary later on, you can choose up to 15 feet. Is that not enough for you? Because you also get the peerless inventor feat. You gain the inventor skill feat without having to have the proficiency for it. You can spend downtime in a common formula that you don't know. So it's like a crafting activity. You can spend half the price of the formula up front, attempt a crafting check, and on success either finish the formula by paying the difference or work longer on it to decrease the price, making more bombs, which is important for you because bombs is your main gimmick. For our first level inventor feat, go no, I created you. Attempt to counteract an effect that caused confusion or controlled over your construct companion, using your crafting modifier for the counteract check and half your level rounded up for the counteract level. So, you know, you don't stab yourself with your glider, that'd be a dumb mistake. For our natural ambition, pick explosive leap. You can jump in 30 feet in any direction without touching the ground, but you must land on a space of solid ground or else you fall using your next action. Bombs, that's my only explanation for this feat. At level 2, let's get some pumpkin bombs in here with the alchemist archetype. You become trained in the alchemical bombs and crafting. If you're already training crafting, you become trained in the skill of your choice. Pick stealth, because why not? Become trained in the alchemist class DC. For a skill feat, get intimidating glare. When you do, demoralize loses the auditory trait and gains the visual trait. And you don't take a penalty if the creature doesn't understand your language. That goblin mask is haunting. I think it bypasses languages. At level 3, get expert overdrive. Become expert in crafting. On a successful use of overdrives, you can increase the additional damage you gain by 1. General feat, get fleet for a 5 extra feet of movement for an even 30 at this level. Reconfigure, you're going to attempt to change the modifications of your innovation by spending 1 day of downtime tinkering with it and attending a crafting check with a high DC for your level. On success, you can change one modification you've chosen for your innovation to a different modification of the same kind, such as initial, breakthrough, or revolutionary. Increase athletics to expert with our skill increase. At inventor level 4, for our inventor feat get basic concoction. From alchemist to get quick bomb, you can interact to draw a bomb then strike with it. For a skill feat get powerful leap, you can leap, you can jump 5 feet up in the air vertically, and you can increase the distance you jump horizontally by 5 feet as well, giving you decent hops, enough to keep up with Spider-Man at least. At level 5, get ability boost from intelligence, constitution, strength, and charisma. For ancestry feat, get burn it. Your spells and alchemical items that deal fire damage gain a status bonus to damage equal to half a spell's level or quarter level items level. You also gain a plus 1 status bonus to any persistent fire damage you deal. Inventor weapon expertise, your ranks in simple weapons, martial arms, and armed attacks increase up to expert. Skill increase, like get deception up to expert. At level 6, get an inventor feat, get expert alchemy. Your advanced alchemy increases to 3, and at the 10th level, it increases to 5. For a skill feat, get magical crafting. When you select this feat, you can select 4 formulas of 4 common magic items of 2nd level or lower. Personally, I would pick bombs. That seems to be the best go-to for him right now. At level 7, you get breakthrough innovation. I would pick advanced weaponry to give our construct one of their unarmed attacks. Give the modular head to give it bludgeoning, piercing, or slashing damage. So the glider can ram into people, stab people with the spikes on its body, or move in the way to cut people around it. General feat, grab ride to automatically see any ride checks for our glider. Lightning reflexes, our reflex saves increase up to expert. Master overdrive, become a master in crafting. On a successful overdrive, you now deal 2 additional damage, increasing from the original expert overdrive. Skill increase, get intimidation up to expert. And weapon specialization, you deal 2 additional damage, weapons, armor, attacks, which you're expert in, and 3 if you're a master. For our inventor feat, we're going to get advanced construct companion for our glider to increase its strength, dexterity, constitution, wisdom modifiers all by 1. You increase armor attack damage from 1 dice to 2 dice. Increase its rank in perception and all saving throws up to expert. Increase its ranks in intimidation, stealth, and survival up to trained. If they're already trained in these skills, increase it up to expert. You now change its size so it can either be medium, small, or large. Personally, I'll go with large, so now we can ride it. For a skill feat, get intimidating prowess. In situations where you can physically menace the target, you can coerce or demoralize. You can increase the circumstance bonus of your intimidation check by 1 and ignore the penalty for not sharing the language. If your strength score is 20 or higher and you're a master intimidation, this bonus increases by 2, which will be great by the end of the build. At level 9, you get an ancestry feat, get cling. If your target moves while you're hanging onto it after a successful strike, you can choose to move with the target. Target is released if you choose not to move with it at the start of your next turn, or if the target escapes. If it tries to escape, it follows the normal rules of escape, except you can use your acrobatics DC to end the cling instead of the conditions normally needed to end an escape action. Offensive boost, your improvements to any strikes that rely on your innovation deal an extra 1d6, typically determined by the boost you chose. Personally, I'll go slashing damage, because you have those sharp blades at the end of your glider. Inventor expertise, your inventor DC saves go up to expert, and your athletics go up to master with our skill increase at this level. At level 10, you get ability boosts from the intelligence, constitution, strength, and charisma. For your inventor feat, get calculated splash. When you throw an alchemical bomb with the splash trait, you can choose to have the bomb deal splash damage equal to your intelligence modifier instead of the normal amount. For a skill feat, get specialty crafting and make it alchemy. You gain a plus 1 circumstance bonus to checks to craft items of the alchemist type, or if you're a master in crafting, that bonus increases up to 2. You're really good at making those bombs. At level 11, get a general feat, grab the tough feat to increase our health by our level. Medium armor expertise, your ranks in light armor, medium armor, and armor defense increase up to expert. Resolve, your will save is increased up to master. When you roll success on a will save, you critical success instead. Skill increase, get intimidation up to master, because come on, it's Willem Dafoe, he's going to be pretty scary. At level 12 of inventor, you get the master alchemy feat. Your advanced alchemy increases to 7. For every level you gain beyond 12th, your advanced alchemy increases up by 1. For a skill feat, get terrified retreat. When you critically succeed a demoralized action, if the target's level is lower than yours, you get that target fleeing for 1 round. At level 13, you get alertness. Your rank per perception increases up to expert. For ancestry feat, get kneecap. Make a strike with one of your melee weapons or a melee armored attack. This attack does not deal damage, but on a hit, the target takes a negative 10 foot status penalty to their speed or a negative 15 on a critical hit. As with all his penalties of speed, it can reduce a creature's speed below 5. This is really good against Spider-Man, who's really maneuverable and really fast. Complete reconfiguration. You can spend downtime to reconfigure innovation and succeed on a crafting check. You can swap any number of modifications, swap your offensive boost, or retain any number of modification feats rather than one. Inventor weapon mastery. Your rank in simple weapons, martial weapons, armed attacks, increase up to master. For skill increase, get deception up to master as well. At level 14, get an inventor feat, get far lobber. It's a nice, good feat. You get a 30-foot throw instead of a normal 20. For a skill feat, get impeccable crafter. When you roll a success on a crafting check to make an item of a type you choose with specialty crafting, you get a success instead. With your level, it shouldn't be hard to get this a lot, so I would go with making bombs. Really make those bombs. At level 15, you get ability boost from intelligence, constitution, strength, and charisma. For a general feat, get incredible initiative. You get a plus 2 circumstance bonus to all initiative rolls. Greater weapon specialization, the damage from weapon specialization increases to 4, weapons and armed attacks which you're an expert in, and 6 if you're a master. Legendary overdrive, become legendary in crafting. On a successful overdrive, you gain additional damage of a total of 3, replacing the last increase of master overdrive. Revolutionary innovation, pick the flight chassis for your companion, you now have a flying glider. Excellent. Now, skill increase, I got athletics, the legendary, so we can really have the strength to beat out Spider-Man, maybe. I'm not quite sure. I think Spider-Man might be overall stronger. At Inventor level 16, you get an Inventor feat, a debilitating bomb. You mix a substance into the bomb that causes one of the following effects: dazzle, deafening, flat-footed, or a negative 5 status penalty to speed. If the attack with the bomb hits, the target must succeed a fortitude saving throw or suffer the effect until the start of your next turn. Use your class DC for this saving throw. Honestly, I think dazzled or deafened would be really good as a bomb, but, you know, depending on your circumstance, whatever you need for the situation. Skill feat, get cloud jump, triple the distance on your long jump, so you can jump 60 feet on a successful D20 check. And when you high jump, you can use the calculation of a long jump, but don't triple the distance. Spider-Man tends to use the environment a lot in his fights, so you need to use the environment as well. At level 17, for an ancestry feat, get Reckless Abandon once per day for the remainder of your turn. If you roll a failure, critical failure on a saving throw against a harmful effect, you get a normal success instead. Furthermore, enemies and hazards that would damage you this turn roll the minimum damage possible. Inventive Mastery, your rank and your Inventor class DC increases to Master. Juggernaut, your rank and Fortitude saves increase to Master. When you roll a success on a Fortitude save, you get a critical success instead. For skill increase, you get Deception up to Legendary, so you can lie with the best of them. At level 18, you get an Inventor feat and you get Engine of Destruction. You can command your innovation instead of its normal actions. It strides only once, but attacks a strike within every foe within 30 feet with a +2 circumstance bonus to those attacks. So press your little pad, have it destroy everything in its path. For skill feat, you can craft anything as long as you have the appropriate crafting skill feat, such as magical crafting for magical items, and you meet the item's level and proficiency requirement. You can ignore just about any other requirement, such as having a specific ancestry providing spells. This means you can access all kinds of bombs with little to no requirements, which is fun and great for Green Goblin. At level 19, you get a journal feat, get diehard a dieting condition of 5 instead of 4, infinite invention. During your daily preparations, you automatically fix your innovation if it's destroyed or broken. You can change it to a different kind of innovation, such as armor or weapon, and change the modifications and offensive boost to match it. So, you don't need your glider today? Put it into armor. You want to have a badass weapon to beat Spider-Man to death with? Pick that. Medium armor mastery. Your ranks in light armor, medium armor, as well as armor defense increase with the master. And for skill increase, you get intimidation with the legendary to really match that Green Goblin energy. At level 20, for our last ability boost, from intelligence, dexterity, strength, and charisma. For our inventor feat, get full automation. You have an extra action that you can use to command your construct or your innovation, or to provide one of the actions if you choose to spend two actions to command your construct. So always have it moving with you on top. This is a guaranteed movement action every single turn. Skill feat, get scared to death. Attempt an intimidation check against the will DC of a living creature within 30 feet of you that you can sense or observe and that can sense and observe you. The target can't hear you, doesn't understand your language, you have to take a -4 circumstance penalty. Even on a failure or a success, they get a fright condition, 1 or 2, depending on how bad they fail. So, either scare them to death or make them scared. That's the way you deal it here in Green Goblin Town, baby! So, with all that being said, do you want to rule this city, or would you rather just fight to the death? Let's start with our glider. You have lesser cover while you're riding it. It has a health pool of 170. It deals 2d8 slashing damage. It can move 40 feet and, of course, fly. We can craft up to 16th level alchemy items, which includes us wonderful toys such as bottled lightning, crystal shards, blight bombs, all of which has several different effects to help you take down Spider-Man. Without the flourish trait on the quick lobber, I can't see why you can't spend 3 actions to throw bombs while using your extra action to command your glider to move 40 feet while flying. With a pouch of bottled lightning, for example, you can add a total of 9d6 plus 18 splash damage for a minimum of 27 and a high of 72. Our fists aren't slacking that much either, with 3d4 plus 18 plus 15 on a combo for a low of 36 and a high of 45. That's not even including overdrive if we decide to go into that, which can deal damage up to as high as 72. So Norman can punch out Spider-Man if he really needs to. You chose your path while others chose the way of the hero. The cunning warrior attacks neither the body nor the mind. They attack the heart. So become the Green Goblin, throw your bombs to wreak absolute havoc, fire on that glider, screaming like Willem Dafoe can. Just don't forget who we are, who we choose to be. Now choose.